as early as the 1950s, after only about two decades of writing. Nick Joaquin was already considered an important, if not the most important, Filipino writer of his time. Critics raved about his works. His first book, published in 1952, included short stories that scholars later declared as classics in Philippine writing in English. These stories continue to be read, studied, and adapted into various forms, from film to theater. Like Nick Joaquin's later stories, they discuss the opposition of passion and reason, of spirit and flesh, and sometimes their reconciliation. In the 1970s, Nick Joaquin wrote children's stories that were reimaginings of Philippine folklore. Portrait of the Artist as Filipino is said to be the best known and most performed Filipino play. First staged in Intramuros in 1955 to critical and popular acclaim, it was made into a film and subsequently translated into Filipino. The central image in the play, that of Ineas carrying his father out of a burning city, has been read as an underlying theme of Nick Joaquin's writings, that the present bears the past on its shoulders as it finds its way into the future. Nick Joaquin started writing in his teens. His poetry first came out in the Tribune in 1934 when he was only 17, while his short fiction first appeared in the Sunday Tribune magazine in 1937. Between 1934 and 1941, he published short stories and poems in periodicals. He continued to write fiction and essays during the war. After the war, Nick Joaquin spent 2 years at the seminary in Hong Kong. Upon coming home, he was hired as a proofreader at the Philippines Free Press, which had already been publishing his short stories. In 1955, by means of two fellowships, Nick Joaquin wrote his first novel while traveling in the United States, Spain, and Mexico. Published in 1961, The Woman Who Had Two Navels received the first Stonehill Award and the Republic Cultural Heritage Award. Set in Hong Kong after World War II, the novel discusses the Filipino exiles' search for redemption. Nick Joaquin rejoined the Philippines Free Press in 1957 and stayed until 1970. Known as Quijano de Manila, he produced an average of 50 articles a year, covering topics from Communist China to the Beatles. Applying a literary style in his reporting, Nick Joaquin raised journalistic reportage to an art form that reached the public in many ways. He worked on the belief that he could create his own brand of journalism, a new journalism, he said, that was as creative as any poem or novel. He wrote riveting stories from his assignments, whether they were about a basketball game or a murder case. The House on Zapote Street, one of his popular journalistic pieces, is also a piece of social history that was later adapted into film. From the 1970s onwards, Nick Joaquin's essays on Philippine personality, society, and culture was collected in several books that colorfully depict life in Manila in the last quarter of the 20th century. He was called the Mega Buck Writer, who was also commissioned to write biographies that are engrossing historical narratives as well. As in his literary works, Nick Joaquin celebrated the virtues of our country's past in his prose. his writings discuss the dynamic process of Philippine becoming. Culture, he declared, is itself history. Identity, he wrote, is not what we were but what we have become, what we are at this moment. He emphasized the value of history and tradition in his own poetics. Critics coined the term Joaquinesque to describe his vibrant use of language, specifically his Spanish-flavored English, as well as the playful injection of vernacular expressions in his works. Nick Joaquin has contributed to the validation of Philippine English as a language in its own right. As the poet Emmanuel Lacaba pointed out, such writing may be lush and incomprehensible to the foreigner, but it is living and exciting to the Filipino. In 1996, Nick Joaquin received the Ramon Magsaysay Award for Journalism, Literature, and Creative Communication. 20 years earlier, he was named National Artist for Literature. Nick Joaquin is known for his generosity to and encouragement of young writers. According to the writer Mara Lanod, almost a generation of writers look up to him as a great influence on their writing. As literary editor of the Free Press, he chose which stories and poems should be published in the widely circulated magazine and set the standard for Philippine writing in English. He continued to do so as editor-in-chief of Philippines Graphic, beginning in 1990. He had successfully pushed for the return of fiction and poetry to its pages. Nick Joaquin never stopped writing. Towards the latter part of his life, he maintained columns in newspapers and even published a magazine. He served the Graphic until his death in 2004. It is in his honor that the Philippine Graphic has chosen to hold the Nick Joaquin Literary Awards, which seeks to keep his legacy alive for present and future Filipino writers and readers. Sé de un lugar cerca del sol, sé de un lugar.